Hey, so I'm Gaurav. I'm from Calgary, Alberta, Canada, and I'm just here to talk about the ANS REWIRE program and my experience with it. It came into my life last year. Today, it's 2020 right now, and I found the program in June of 2019. But prior to that, I had been struggling with fibromyalgia for the better part of about 10 years. Largely undiagnosed when I got started because I didn't know what it was. But as things went on, I found myself getting more and more fatigued, and the sudden pain, bouts of pain and things like that happening. But I was a bit young, so I didn't really pay much attention to it. I just kind of, sloughed it off and kept going on with life. And eventually the symptoms kind of ramped up as it were. And I realized around 2014, 2015, that I was having these bouts of really, really real fatigue. I mean, we're talking about sometimes days, sometimes weeks on end, just exhausted, unable to move. I was talking about brain fog. I was talking about pain and just things happening that I couldn't quite explain. I was relatively fit. I went to the gym and martial arts classes and swimming, but it was getting tougher and tougher. Yet, there was no real basis for it. We thought maybe it's dietary. Maybe it's I'm overworking myself. I'm not sleeping. So I had a number of diagnoses done. We thought maybe sleep apnea or something. It wasn't that. We thought maybe it's diet, but it just kept going. And it wasn't until, I kind of ignored it again, as you do when you're young and a little bit stupid. The following year is when I think it was my wife who just said, maybe it's something else, it just felt like, everything in my body started to just kind of catch fire, for lack of a better term. And it was getting worse. I couldn't really go on vacation. We had these things planned and it was just painful. And so I started getting more symptoms. So I started getting brain fog, more and more so, memory loss, stiffness. Walking was becoming a little bit more difficult. I would be bedridden. And then doctors thought maybe it's, oddly enough, they thought it was, what's that stuff, ADD, ADHD, which is an odd diagnosis, but I mean, I guess they're trying. So, that wasn't it. And they put me on a couple of medications, which I immediately got off of because that wasn't it. And it kind of got worse and progressed from there. And then it just got really, really bad around 2017, 2018, to the point where I knew that this had to be something else. And I started Googling my symptoms and really diving deep. And I came across fibromyalgia. Honestly, I didn't want to think it was that. I had come across the term a few times, but in my head, fibromyalgia was kind of like MS. I didn't know any better. I was like, that just means I'm going to be in a wheelchair or something like that forever. But as it turns out that through research, I found out, it's debilitating pain and, the cause is unknown, as the common literature says. So eventually I started to seek a diagnosis in 2018 and, went to various experts and they thought it was ADHD. They prescribed medications for that, but it wasn't. So I went and started to really get deep into it. And then we did finally come across a specialist who kind of was purported to know what she was doing in the field. And she did eventually diagnose me with fibromyalgia because she said, it's not your iron, it's not this, it's not that, it's, it's got to be fibromyalgia, which she just said is a catch-all term for you have undiagnosed pain. I said, that's very useful. Not really, but it is what it is. And I just figured, do I have to live with this thing? How do you get around it? So I've been very solution-focused my whole life. At least I had a label to work off of. So as such, I figured, if it's fibromyalgia, what can I do to get over it? Because I always look at things as if you got it, you can kind of unget it. If you got sick, you can treat it like anything else, like a cold, right? So I started looking into it. And most of the causes out there that are accepted, or at least were at the time, were it's diet, it's overwork, it's stress, it's obviously unknowns, neuropathy, it's in your head. So I was recommended everything, anything you can imagine. So I did diet change. I went on low carb for about a year, maybe more than that, probably more than that, about a year and a half, which was fine. Like it had its own side benefits, but it didn't really do much for pain. I did flotation tanks, which again, temporarily, I felt better. More supplements than I could possibly imagine. Every multivitamin, there was a stuff called collagen was a big one that people kept prescribing to me. So collagen powder. Then it was like, well, do some heat. So I bought a sauna and I sat in that for ages. Then there's somebody who's like, well, maybe you got to do cold therapy. So I started doing cold therapy. then alternating cold and heat, and then massage therapy. And I was prescribed painkillers. Not a fan of them. I mean, yeah, it was temporarily okay, but I knew that numbing the pain wasn't the answer. There had to be something beyond it. CBD, THC, which again was probably the best painkiller at the end of the day, but I mean, who wants to do that every day if you don't have to? So that at least got me through the worst of it. And then honestly, I almost went for stem cell treatment at one point. Somebody said, well, you know, so-and-so did stem cell treatment and they're fine. And so I started saving up for that. And I almost committed to that. And then I finally ran into Dan's course. It would have been June of 2019, just randomly surfing the internet. And then there was Dan. And I looked at the course and I said, this guy's theory makes sense, because I actually had experienced a period of spontaneous recovery in July of 2018. I went to Kelowna, and then I just somehow, I don't know how I did it, but I got it out of my mind. I don't know how I did it. But for a week, I was pain-free. I went hiking, and it was amazing. But because I didn't know how I did it or why it worked, it inevitably came back, because I didn't trust what I had done. But I knew what Dan was talking about was true. So I did the course. On and off initially for multiple reasons for the first 2 or 3 months. But once I really pursued it, at that point, I'd say I maybe become, I think I talked to Dan, I think I said I was about 40 or 50% recovered. So I went from 40 to 50% to about, well, not about, 800% recovered. It was a phenomenal experience. But yes, I was officially fiber free. And since then, life has been phenomenal. I mean, I've been back at the gym. It was pretty scary, honestly, the first week going back, because I'm like, oh, well, you know, what if this, what if that? But it was phenomenal. I was back to doing what I used to do, back to my classes, back to guitar, which is a passion of mine, playing with my nieces and nephews, because I remember the pain of not being able to spend time with them and being exhausted and falling asleep when they wanted to go to the park. It was no fun. But now, hey, I run around with them every weekend. That's phenomenal. I can work out. I can travel, walk, play, just enjoy life. So what I recommend to anybody, realistically, is if you've got CFS, fibromyalgia, ME, any of these symptoms, Dan's really nailed it. I mean, he's gone through the process himself. He's cured himself. He's done the research. He's got so much to back him up. And as far as I'm concerned, it's practically saved my life. I mean, it's given me my life back, really. Like, there's no, it might be hyperbolic, but it really has. It's given my life back. So I would recommend checking it out. It's a phenomenal program. And yeah, that's what I have to say about it.